The topic of Final Fantasy XV coming to PC has become quite the interesting saga over the past year or so. However, it was actually first discussed almost 4 years ago, shortly after the switch from Final Fantasy Versus 13 to Final Fantasy XV. During one of their Square Enix Presents segments at E3 2013, Yoshihasa Hashimoto, Square Enix's chief technology officer, revealed that Final Fantasy XV was being developed in a PC environment and that platforms capable of supporting DirectX 11 would be strong candidates for receiving the final version. At this point, they had only announced that Final Fantasy XV would be coming to the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One, so it was something of a tease for a PC release, as the only other major platform on the market, the Wii U, didn't support DirectX 11. Hashimoto also noted that if a PC version were to be released, it would require an expensive machine to run. They were therefore waiting to gauge audience demand before making a decision on whether to make a PC version. Since that time, the topic of a PC release has come up over and over again, with Square Enix issuing similar responses, consistently teasing fans about a potential release. Heck, Square Enix even showed the game running on a high-end PC at this year's Game Developers Conference. And it's for this reason that HT, one of our Patreon supporters, asked me to make a video about this exact topic. Today, I'm therefore going to be talking about why I'm pretty much certain that Final Fantasy XV will come out for PC. Just as a side note before we get onto that though, if you'd like us to make a video about a topic of your choosing, please head over to our Patreon to find out how. Oh, and also be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Right, as I mentioned, Square Enix first spoke on record about the possibility of a PC version for Final Fantasy XV on the 19th of June, 2013. Since then, they have spoken about the issue quite a few times. Yoshinori Kitase spoke to Eurogamer in 2014, where he said that they would be interested in bringing future Final Fantasy games to the PC following the success of the Final Fantasy XIII trilogy on PC. But we had to wait a little while longer for our next comment, as Satoshi Kitade, one of the programmers working on Final Fantasy XV, noted in a post on the official Final Fantasy XV forums that the pre-beta build is currently running on both development PCs and the PS4, though the latter still has areas that require optimization and adjustments due to memory. However, this statement had a lot of miscommunication in it, and this was cleared up by Tabata when he was attending Comic Fiesta when he was asked about the pre-beta version of Final Fantasy XV running on PCs. He said, "Really? Where did you hear this? If anything, it's a misunderstanding. There will be no PC port. We have never planned for it. The game was originally developed on the PC first, and what we said was how the pre-beta works very smoothly on the PC and our optimizations are being done for the consoles. Please do not misunderstand." But he couldn't stop there though, as everyone knows that fans need a good carrot. To round out his answer to the question, he said, "If a proper PC version is to be made, then many changes have to be made and a lot of things have to be reconsidered before such a move can be made." Prior to Uncovered, sleuths at NeoGAF then noticed Steam mentioned in the source code of the website, but this was likely due to laziness, as the same source code appeared on a Tomb Raider website and Square Enix promptly removed it. But by the time Uncovered came about, Tabata insisted that he would be taking a good, hard look at the PC version and what they would need to do. GameStop, who of course were part of the whole Final Fantasy XV delay fiasco, also published an advertising campaign on their official website with a massive PC logo on it, but much like the Uncovered code, this was chalked off as an error. A week later, still coming from Uncovered, Tabata spoke to French publication Jeuxvideo and said that he wanted to do a PC version after the console version released. However, it wouldn't just be a simple port, they would want to make it much more technically elaborate. And in October, after the delay had been announced, Tabata mentioned in an interview with Spanish publication Vida Extra that if they were to work on a PC version, it would take them at least a year. Lastly, before the GDC demo that I prefaced all of this with, Tabata spoke to Famitsu, reiterating that he personally wants to see a release of the game on PC, if only so they can experiment with platform-specific nuances like mods and other pieces of user-generated content like quests. So yeah, they've talked about it a lot, without ever confirming a thing. The last few references are quite interesting though, as Tabata has expressed an interest in wanting to do a PC version, and it can't come as too much of a surprise. During an AMA for Final Fantasy Type-0 HD, Tabata noted that he's been a supporter of Steam since the release of Half-Life 2. And in my mind, if the director of the game wants to make it for PC, surely you'd think that they would make it for PC. I'd also like to highlight here that despite Tabata saying in the AMA that there were no plans for the PC release of Final Fantasy Type-0 HD, they did announce one a few months later. Anyway, outside of Tabata's tantalizing teases, which are pretty much compelling on their own, I can point to a few things that strongly suggest that Final Fantasy XV will release on PC at some point in the future. For one, pretty much every other Final Fantasy game is now available on the platform. The first Final Fantasy to release on PC was, of course, the original Final Fantasy. It released on the MSX2, which was a home computer released by Microsoft in Japan on the 1st of June 1989. However, the first game to release on the PC in the West was Final Fantasy VII. This, like Final Fantasy VIII after it, was published by Eidos Interactive, but after the release of Final Fantasy VIII, Squaresoft cooled their interest in the PC. That was until Final Fantasy XI. Sakaguchi, while setting up Square Pictures, started playing EverQuest, and he became hooked and was impressed by the increasing popularity of MMORPGs. He therefore convinced the higher-ups at Square to make an MMO and suggested that it should be based around Final Fantasy. But it wasn't until much later that we'd start seeing offline titles appearing on the PC again. And if you head over to Steam right now, you'll notice that you can purchase a ton of different games. There's Final Fantasy 3, Final Fantasy 4 plus the after years, Final Fantasy 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10-2, 13, 13-2, Lightning Returns, Final Fantasy 14, Type-0 HD, and even Mobius. And the impressive statistic behind these releases is that collectively, excluding Mobius as it's free to play, if we're looking at Steam releases exclusively, they have been bought over 5.1 million times. By these standards, even if Final Fantasy XV Steam sales were on par with that of Final Fantasy XIII, it would sell around 650 additional units. And that's ignoring the fact that there's been way more clamour for a PC release of Final Fantasy XV than there ever was for that of Final Fantasy XIII, so you'd expect it to sell even more. And if there's one thing Square Enix love, and any company for that matter, it's sales and their associated revenue. Lest we also forget that Tabata set an internal target of 10 million sales, something that a PC release would get them much closer to achieving. Nier Automata, another Square Enix game, has also just released on PC and sold shy of 175,000 units. I think it's safe to say that Final Fantasy XV on PC would sell, and it would sell very well. The one thing I would say that's stopping them from just plowing ahead with it is that given how badly Final Fantasy XIII was received when it released on PC, I can understand why they want to make sure it's actually good. Sure, they got better with the recent releases, but even Final Fantasy Type-0 HD had some pretty fundamental issues with its port. They just can't afford to make the same mistakes with Final Fantasy XV on PC. At this point, I firmly believe that they are working on a PC version of Final Fantasy XV, and that, as Tabata said, it will take them at least a year to realise. By that point, we'll have seen the first year of content that Tabata has consistently spoken about, and with the release of the PC version, which it sounds like they want to make the definitive version of the game, this would be the perfect way to push things on a little further, should they wish. I mean, they've already started testing the waters about a second year of downloadable content, so it would make perfect sense for them to do so. Alright guys, so that's why I believe Final Fantasy XV will arrive on PC and that they're working on it right now. What do you guys think? Are you in agreement that it's pretty much going to arrive? Or do you think it will never see the light of day? Let us know in the comments below, and if you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and subscribe. If you'd like to support our channel, and even get a video made like HT did, please head over to our Patreon at patreon.com/ffunion. These awesome folks have already done so why not join them? Alright, thanks for watching guys, this is Daryl signing out. I will see you next time.